So how can we use the velocity components and the stream function to actually sketch what the streamlines are in an actual flow? Well, let's look at an example. Let's say we have velocity components such that u equals 4y plus 3 and v equals 2x plus 6. And remember, when we're defining these stream functions, they're in two dimensions. So the first thing we want to know, is this a physically possible flow? What that means is this incompressible? And for that to be the case, du dx plus dv dy has to equal zero. And just by looking at it, you can tell that that's the case. So now let's introduce our stream function. So by definition, u is the derivative of the stream function with respect to y, which is 4y plus 3. And so we separate and integrate in order to find this part of the stream function. And when we do that, we come up with that the stream function equals 2y squared plus 3y plus some function of x. Now, let's do it for v. So v is the negative derivative of the stream function with respect to x, which equals 2x plus 6. Again, we separate and integrate, and this time it is 2x plus 6 dx, but let's not forget that negative sign. So now our stream function equals negative x squared minus 6x plus some function of y. And when we combine these two, we come up with a stream function that is 2y squared plus 3y minus x squared minus 6x plus a constant. So how do we go from there to actually drawing streamlines? Well, the first thing we're going to do is set this constant equal to zero. And in order to get different streamlines, we change the number of the stream function and change it to different constants. So we can set this equal to zero, we can set it equal to one, we can set it equal to two, we can set it equal to any constant we want. So let me show you what happens and how you work this if we set the stream function equal to zero. Now you have to solve this in terms of y. And so our y is going to equal minus 3/4 plus or minus 1/4 times the square root of 9 plus 8x squared plus 48 times x. By the way, I didn't figure this out on my own. I put it in a computer program and let it solve it for me. So now that you have this equation, what do you do with it? Well, you take something like Excel, and you have an x column, a y one column, and a y two column. And your x's can go from any number that you want. Generally, you're going to want to start with zero. So what I did here is I went from 0.1 all the way to 1. And now you solve for your y1 such that you use the positive minus 3/4 plus 1/4, etc. And then you use it for the negative. And then you plot it. And what you'll end up with is a plot that looks like this. So these are your streamlines, and you can do it negative x's, etc. These are your streamlines for our our streamline equals zero. Now, instead of setting it equal to zero, you can use this stream function to equal, for example, 2 or 4, and you solve it for y. Except now your equation is going to be, for example, 2 equals 2y squared plus 3y minus x squared minus 6x. So you solve for y and then plot this particular series or families of streamlines.